It's from Super Videos, back for another video for Season 10 of The Walking Dead. This is my Things You May Have Missed and Easter Eggs for Season 10, Episode 15, which was called The Tower. If you have not checked out my previous Easter egg videos for the second half of Season 10, you can click the link that's going to drop on the top right to go check those out. Without further ado, let's jump right into it. So the first point I want to go through comes from the opening minutes. So of course we have King Ezekiel, Eugene, and Yumiko coming across a loner survivor named Juanita Sanchez, who likes to be called Princess. This is actually a comic character, obviously, but one thing that in the comics we didn't see was an interaction between Ezekiel and Princess. And why that's important is because, well, Ezekiel calls himself King. So he has this kind of larger-than-life personality and he puts on an act sort of thing. Now, Princess also calls herself Princess because she, in a way, puts on an act and hides her true identity in a way. Now, in the comics, King Ezekiel was dead long before they met up with Princess. Now, the interesting thing is Juanita said that you can call me Princess. When Eugene asked why Princess and not Queen, she said because Queen makes me sound old and pretentious. Now, the interesting part is right after that scene, Ezekiel introduces himself, but instead of calling himself King Ezekiel, he just says, I am Ezekiel. The next thing I want to go through, the title of this episode is The Tower. And also, if we take a look at this shot that was in the episode, we actually see Alexandria overrun. But in the background, you actually do notice the water tower. Now, the water tower is actually part of a very iconic and gruesome scene from the comics that involves Father Gabriel. And so the fact that they called this episode The Tower, and we have the tower in the background here, is a direct reference or a direct Easter egg at that iconic comic moment. Now, before this episode aired, a lot of comic fans were under the impression that we were actually going to see that comic death in this episode, but didn't happen. With that said, I think there is a possibility that they're going to still have that death, but in the finale. And it might not necessarily be the exact same death, but it'll be an adaptation and a remixed version of that same exact death. Now, will Father Gabriel get that? That remains to be seen. I think that he is very likely to get that, but it's possible that they might give that to someone else. Now, one thing I want to mention, stay tuned for my death predictions video for the finale. That's going to come right after this one. And in that video, I'll go through all of the characters I think are most likely to die and also characters who I think have a chance of getting killed off in the finale. But I thought the usage of the tower was a great Easter egg for the iconic comic moment, even if they don't end up using it or anything related to it in the next episode. Next thing I want to mention is when the Whispers and the Walker Herd overrun Alexandria, that's actually a direct callback to the events of Season 6, Episode 9, which was called No Way Out. In that episode, we had the walkers overrun Alexandria and the survivors had to use the guts trick to walk amongst the herd and to get out of Alexandria. Now, in this episode, Season 10, Episode 15, they actually just showed us the aftermath of the Alexandria safe zone being overrun. And they switched up the story a little bit and had it so that there were no survivors at Alexandria when it was overrun. Now, the reason I think they did that is so that the events of this episode don't feel like the exact same thing. So it doesn't feel like a repetition of the story. Because if they had it so that there were some characters there and they had to use the guts trick or they just had to hide in their houses, it would have felt a lot like No Way Out. So they wanted to get away from that a little bit and change it up a little bit. So I think that's the reason why they ended up having it so that they show us the aftermath of the safe zone being overrun rather than showing the events leading up to and survivors having to hide from the walkers. Based on the trailer of the next episode, it seems like they are still going to use a variation of that storyline, but with a difference that it's not going to take place at Alexandria. It's going to take place in the tower that the survivors were hiding at. If we take a look at the trailer, we do see that There is going to be a moment in time where characters are going to wear ponchos, cover themselves in guts, and try to walk through the herd. So that means that they are going to revisit that story and potentially bring a remixed version of that to the TV show. Now, what I also thought that they should have done during the Whispers arc, which they didn't do, was they could have utilized what the Whispers are and why they're so deadly by having it so that the Whispers allow the herd to come in, open doors, break through walls, and make it impossible for survivors to hide. Because at that point, it's not just about fighting the walkers. It's about fighting back against the Whispers' strategy, which is to basically break through any barrier that they find and help the walkers go through those barriers. But I think based on the trailer of the next episode, it seems like that might be where they're going with it, because there are scenes in the trailer where we see someone, most likely Beta, breaking through walls. So I think that it's possible that they might be doing that in the finale, which I am super excited about. The next thing I want to mention is when we have this scene where walkers are getting into the Alexandria safe zone, there is a moment where the walkers step on a tomato. Now, that's a very cool callback because it refers to something that happened in season 9, episode 3, which was called Warning Signs. In that episode, we actually had Rick pick up a tomato that they had grown. And that was symbolism for the growth of the community and for them becoming independent and becoming more of a civilized community. Rick put that tomato in that episode on Carl's grave. And I think that was also symbolism in that episode for Carl's legacy living on and being the reason for this growth. Now, the opposite is true in season 10, episode 15. The walkers walking over the tomato is a symbolism of the destruction of the growth that they had and the destruction of the civilization and the organized community that they had built back then. Next callback is something that we saw with Negan in this episode. In this episode, we had Negan cooking for Lydia. Now, that was a great callback to something that happened in season 7, episode 8, Hearts Still Beating, when Negan came to Alexandria, brought Carl back after his rogue mission, cooked Carl spaghetti, and fed it to him. The next thing I want to mention, which is something some people may have missed, is the survivor's strategy in this episode was actually to hide temporarily and then make the Whispers think that they have gone to Oceanside and basically push them towards Oceanside. Now, we don't know what they had planned once they got to Oceanside. We don't know what type of traps, but we did know that their primary goal was to push the Whispers towards Oceanside, and that appeared to have worked until Beta noticed something that redirected him towards the right direction. We'll get to that in a few minutes. But the next callback I want to talk about is Daryl killing the Whisper who was injured is actually a callback to the savior that he killed in season 8, episode 3, which was called Monsters. The minefield that Princess has the survivors going through in season 10, episode 15 is a callback to the minefield that they had in Fear the Walking Dead, season 5, episode 9, which was called Channel 4. This scene right here where we have Princess using the eeny, meeny, miny, mo strategy to pick which direction she's going to go was actually a callback to something that happened in season 6, episode 16, Last Day on Earth, where we had Negan using eeny, meeny, miny, mo to choose his victim. Now, unlike that moment that didn't have a happy ending, Princess's strategy had a happy ending and she ended up finding the right direction out by using this eeny, meeny, miny, mo method. The next thing I want to mention is this scene right here where we have Eugene, Yumiko, King Ezekiel, and Princess finding the door to the garage. In the background, there's some graffiti. Now, what's interesting is there seems to be some clues in the back. For example, behind Princess, we have a drawing of a pig and "Hey, you." Now, that could connect to Princess's larger-than-life personality and her kind of flamboyant characteristics and all of that. Behind the king, we actually see a crown. So that obviously connects to King Ezekiel. So that's a connection there. Behind Yumiko, there isn't really anything there. But behind Eugene, we see a skull. Now, is this giving us a clue that Eugene is going to die? I don't think so. But I think it's interesting that there is a skull behind him. If anything, I think this is a clue or an Easter egg that someone very close to Eugene is going to die. Not necessarily that he is going to die. I think there is a lot of important storylines coming up that involves Eugene. So I think it's a little too early to kill Eugene off, especially with what they have set up with Stephanie and the community that Eugene is communicating with. The next thing I want to mention, right after Yumiko tells Princess that you can join us, Princess says, can I go back to my storage area and grab my stuff? I have food, I have this, I have that. She even says, I have a spear. She actually says, I have a pretty cool spear. Now that's obviously an Easter egg for Comic Princess, because in the comics, Comic Princess has a pretty iconic and pretty cool spear. The other thing I want to mention is she also says, I have some candy. And then right after that, they show Eugene's face. Before they actually found Princess, Eugene and Yumiko were talking about what they could potentially find. Eugene says, I wonder if they have some candy. Judith actually comes clean and says that she communicated with Michonne after the Hilltop battle, after Hilltop was destroyed. So the moment between Judith and Michonne that we see in season 10, episode 13, Michonne's final episode, actually takes place after the events of season 10, episode 11, which was the episode that the Hilltop battle occurred. The next callback I want to talk about is during the conversation Kelly and Carol have. Kelly actually quotes something Connie said back in season 10, episode 1, Lines We Cross, where she said, you not being able to hear is not your disability, it's your superpower. Speaking of Connie, something else that Carol and Kelly talked about, Kelly said that everyone is learning to sign now. Now, what's interesting is that we do see in several scenes the characters using sign to communicate in silence. We had Father Gabriel speaking in sign with Kelly. We also had Aaron and Alden speaking in sign when they were hiding in the windmill. During this scene where we have Beta hearing voices in his head, he actually hears the walkers talking to him or whispering to him. So obviously, he's hallucinating, he's losing his mind, but the voices that Beta heard during this scene were actually supposed to be voices coming from walkers, not other whispers. The next thing I want to mention is, remember this cat that Lydia was feeding? Now that cat was most likely on his way to the tower to be fed, and Beta and the whispers most likely redirected towards where this cat was going, in the hopes that they will end up finding the survivors, which they obviously did. The next thing I want to mention is the building or the tower that the survivors are staying at is actually the same exact building that they filmed back in season 5, episode 8, which was called Coda. So it was the exact same hospital. So they shot that in the same exact place. If you remember, that was the exact same place Beth died and she was carried out by Daryl. Now, does this mean they went back to that exact same spot? Absolutely not. The hospital was in Atlanta. But this tower that they're staying at is close to Alexandria. But it is the same exact location. They filmed it in the exact same spot. But that's basically all of the Easter eggs that I wanted to go through. Hope you guys enjoyed. Stay tuned for my death prediction video for the finale of season 10. That'll be coming out sometime after this, so stay tuned for that. And also, if you don't know already, we're not going to have the finale of season 10 tonight. It's been delayed. But don't worry, what we're going to be doing in this channel is having throwback reactions. So every 2 weeks, we're going to be reacting to an older episode of The Walking Dead. Tonight, we're going to be reacting to an episode. And then 2 weeks after, we're going to be reacting to another episode. Now, the one we're going to react to tonight is season 4, episode 8. The mid-season finale for season 4. Which was a pretty big episode. It was called Too Far Gone. So we're going to be revisiting that and I'm going to be reacting to that. So you can check out my reaction later tonight. With that said, that's it for this video. See you next time for another super video.